Welcome to my Impling only hardcore Iron Man PvP World Series.
Oh god, we're actually doing this. Alright, so, here's the plan. I am going to stay in Puro Puro, hunting Implings until I get the Amulet of Glory. And along the way, I will be collecting every magpie and ninja Impling that I get in order to open for a few additional items. From the magpie Implings, I am looking for a nature tiara. It is the only way to get a nature tiara or talisman through non-combat means without random events. And since random events don't spawn on PvP worlds, this is my only way to get one without gaining combat levels. From the ninja Impling, I want weapon poison plus. So now, I'm gonna run around this maze and spawn dragon Implings until I get the Amulet of Glory, and then we'll open magpies and ninja Implings until I get the items I want from them. That is the plan, anyway. Let's see what happens. Well, it's been 6 million years since the last one, but I just got a dragon Impling. Let's see what we get. Dragon darts. Well, it was worth a great fortune, but unfortunately it won't be doing me much good for a very long time. Well, it's been about 5 minutes, but I got another one. Dragonstone bolt tips. Alright, just gotta drop some crap off at the bank. Not a bad haul so far. I just want to see what my totals are. So we got 3 dragon Impling, 7 ninjas, 22 magpies. So Earth Essence and Eclectic are the main ones I've been focusing on outside of obviously magpies, ninjas, and dragons. And it's hard to total it all up at the moment, but there's been quite a bit of loot so far. So the bank is looking good, but I still haven't got what I wanted yet. Also, as you can see, I've been holding on to all of my magpies and ninjas. I'm gonna open those up after I get the items that I want from the dragon Implings. My dudes, we got another dragon Impling. Let's open it up. Ooh. Dragon bones. And got another dragon. Ooh. Darts, damn it. All right, so here we are on day 3 of the Impling grind. I've been pretty busy outside of game. I haven't been putting in quite as many hours as I normally would, so I'm really only like maybe 5 or 6 hours into this thing. But I have to say, I so regret taking this on. This has to be the worst grind I ever could have decided to do. I thought that hunting Implings would be kind of fun and exciting, because you're constantly catching these little dudes, you're constantly rolling, you know, drop tables. But the sheer chore of actually catching them outweighs any sort of reward you'd get from opening these things. Because first of all, most common Implings don't give you crap that's worth keeping. You get some decent stackables, which you can see here. I've got just about everything that's worth holding on to, as well as a few additional, like, runes and things. But otherwise, the loot is not great. And the more rare Implings actually spawn quite rarely. Dragon Implings don't spawn nearly as often as I thought they did. And so that 1 in 20 drop that I'm trying to get is going to take a very long time. But honestly, the worst part about this grind is that you cannot AFK it at all. So as you can see, I have to sort out all of these imps on screen and try to locate the ones that I want to catch. It requires 100% focus at all times. I'm fully engaged, scanning the screen, trying to find Implings that are worth catching. It is horrible. Now, at the rate I've been going, since I'm doing this without binds, I don't have the ability to freeze the Implings. I have to basically just wait for them to float into my lane or otherwise try and chase after them. I've only been able to spawn about 1 and sometimes 2 dragon Implings per hour, which is fairly average, but it's not great. Oh, somebody's getting PK'd over here. Wait, come back. I want to film this. Oh, rest in peace. Good game. 6 Impling jars and bones. That's all that guy's gonna get. So yeah, the other thing about farming Implings is it's fiercely competitive. There are a lot of Spanish-speaking people here in full PKing gear that hop between worlds. They catch all the rare Implings and kill anybody that tries to compete with them. Luckily, I'm low enough level that none of these other accounts can actually attack me. I've not seen a single Impling hunter that's even close to my combat level. The lowest I've seen here is in the mid-40s. So there's really no danger for me anyway, but since I'm paying so close attention to the screen, there's no chance that anyone could surprise kill me. So yeah, if I'm lucky, the next dragon Impling I open will give me what I'm looking for, but if not, I could be here for another week. There's no telling. It's all RNG, and RNG is not often on my side. But that's enough for now. I guess we'll shut up and continue the grind. Got another dragon Impling? Please be good to me. Nope. Also, there's another Lucky Impling, like, right over here, see him? Lucky Impling. Spawned about three or four of those so far, so they seem to be appearing at almost the exact same rate as Dragon Implings, which is tragic. The thing is, I didn't get enough Hunter levels to actually catch those, but yeah, I would need at least 86 in order to pot up to it. Oh well. Oh my god, Dragon Impling. Dragon Impling! Get him! Get him! Yes! What have you for me, please? Dragon arrows. Okay. 128k. It's not Amulets of Glory, though. Just got another Dragon Impling. Magic Seed. 121k. Oh, look, there's another Lucky Spawn. Yeah, I really should have gone for like 89 Hunter or at least 86 to pot up to it. It's kind of sad seeing so many of these go to waste. That's like the fifth one I've seen. Oh, well. Oh, dig this. So I accidentally opened a Magpie Impling, I guess, because I just caught one. And I got a Nature Tiara, and that was basically the main thing I wanted from a Magpie Impling. Having opened about two of them, I have exactly what I wanted. I guess the remaining 60 in my bank can just sit there. There's no reason to open them now. Man, with that kind of accidental luck, I hope my next Dragon Impling gives me the glories I'm looking for. Look at this massive gathering of Impling Hunters watching this guy get PK'd. Oh, this is incredible. It's so random. There's one, two, three, four people, myself included, standing here watching this fight. And we're all supposed to be hunting dragons. Oh, see, the first 98 was running away, but now he's fighting back. 107 seems shaken. He wasn't prepared for resistance. Oh, there he is with another snare. Ooh, massive damage on both sides. 98's gaining an edge. Oh, here's yet another one in the audience. Alright, right now they're both going back and forth with range, but both have protect from range prayers. Truly a lack of diversity in this fight will be both of their undoing. Ooh, 98 takes a big hit. Looks like he might be out of food. Oh, and that's the KO. 107 taking it almost easily, almost effortlessly. Alright, anyway, back to the hunt. Alright, Dragon Impling. Ah, Magic Seed. Ooh, landing the freeze. 72. He's on the prowl. 80's really backed into a corner here. He can't do anything but eat. He doesn't have the range to strike back. 72 coming in closer. Ooh, and that's the kill. Oh, things are heating up again in the Impling patch. Today we have Ciara, level 71, versus Iaros, level 57. Oh, he's making a run for it. But can 57 escape the wrath of 71? Oh, and there's another snare. Ooh, 71's hot on his tail, pushing through the wheat, but can he land a hit or will he miss? Over and over again. Truly, he's just bashing him over the head with his staff. He did not bring combat runes. This is awkward. Oh, but 57, run for it anyway. Snared again. Oh, can he make it to the exit? 57 was not prepared to fight back. He brought only his net and his mithril armor. Oops, 71 is peeling off. He's giving up. Wait. He's decided he has better things to do. Oh, things are kicking off. 72 hitting 71. That's a one. Oh, he's landed the freeze. He's now standing underneath him. 71 retaliates with a crossbow. He's being shanked to death. What looks like dark light. What the hell was that weapon? Oh, here comes the DDS. 72 pulling back out the magic staff. He's going for another freeze, and that is a land. 71 trying to escape. Can he make it out in time? There's the big 8. Pushes back through the wheat. That's a clever tactic. Trying to make an escape. Oh, big 22 from the rune crossbow. 71 cleverly using his environment to avoid the death dot. Throwing out the rune crossbow again. Oh, 7. That's a weak hit. He's going to need to do more damage than that if he wants to shake this guy. 72 pulling out blood barrage. That's a 16. What weapon is that? Is that Excal? What the fuck is that? I've never seen that sword before. 71 sustaining a lot of damage. Can he survive this? There's another death dot. He needs to push through the wheat right now. Ooh, big 29. He gets his G-Maul out, but he has been dropped. 72 taking the victory. And again, all is peaceful in Puro Puro. There's the Dragon Impling. Please, please, please. Aw. That's the worst one. I am officially dead inside. 100%. There's nothing left. Under the skin is only charcoal. As you could probably ascertain, just based on my inventory, we've been here for quite a while. Oh no, he's getting away. Oh no, he's gone. Crap. Alright, got him. And there's another nature. Belladonna seed trash. Now then, as I was saying, as you could probably ascertain, I've been here for a while. Here are my totals. 405 nature, 110 magpies, 38 ninjas, 10 dragons. That means I'm halfway through the drop rate for the item that I'm looking for, which means, hypothetically speaking, I need to spend twice the time here that I've already spent here. I've long since lost the will to live. Only time will tell if the next episode ever gets posted. I hope I get hit by a car. Pretty good trip. Shit ton more magpies, another ninja, and a dragon! Open. Oof! Fuck! This is like trip number 70,000, as you can see, I have quite a collection of Implings already. Well, a lot of things have happened, last couple of weeks. PvP worlds are a little bit busier again now that Dead Man Mode has finally ended, which is terrifying. Our pal PvP But Hard died horribly. That was unfortunate. So for those who don't know, PvP But Hard was someone else who was doing a PvP world only hardcore Iron Man. He started out by rushing a bunch of quests and was just starting to get into like grinding certain skills when he was killed while training agility by a mage pure. As you can imagine, that's why I have avoided training combat until I'm done with all of the skill grinds that I'm looking for. So as you can see, I'm still level 14. That's not going to be changing for a little while. It's something I'm probably going to talk about a couple videos from now, what my actual plans are for this account, combat levels and things like that. Now, obviously, I said at the beginning that my goal for this account was to hit 1,601 total with at least 199 skill. Technically, I could do that while staying at 14 combat if I really wanted to, but that is not what I'm planning to do. Because while that would certainly be easier, it would also be a lot more boring and just not very exciting. I mean, if I wanted to make a skiller, I wouldn't do a PvP world only account. There would be no point. So rest assured, we will be training combat at some point. Dragon Impling. Oof. Dragonstone bolts. Whoop, got another one. Oof. Dragon longsword. We got one, boys. Oof. Shit. Oop, got another one. Oof. Damn it. Alright, random PKer just handed me a dragon imp. Let's see. Oh my god, I got the glories. Yes! And an elite clue. Finally, we're done! As you can see, this guy just showed up. He stunned it for me. That was exactly what I needed. Thank you so much, I'm in the CC. Lifesaver. I was just on my way to buy another jar generator, and there it was. And then this guy came and gave it to me. And now, I'm free. I'm so free. Ugh. Yes, if I'm gonna be here for a while. Oh, buddy, I wish. The grind is over! There it is! Three amulets of glory. Oh, what a great guy. Now, I'm free! Okay, so now it's time for the final tally on the loot. Here's what we got. So, banking on the most valuable items, we are looking at 6.5 mil. Possibly 7 if I include the other random crap I got, but yeah, there you go. 6.5 mil from spending 2 weeks in Puro Puro hunting dragon implings. So the funny thing is, I actually got the one item that I wanted from the magpie impling, so I don't even need to open these right now. It's not going to provide me any benefit. I might save them for later and open them for clue scrolls. As for the ninja implings, there was a weapon poison plus drop, which would be an upgrade over the poison that I have now. So for doing low level safe spot killing for like quest bosses and stuff, that would actually be a really good drop to have. So I might open those until I get that. So let's see. Probably won't take too long to get. It's about a 1 in 20. Dagonoth hides, onyx bolts, mystic boots, oval machete, snakeskin, DDS. And there it is, the weapon poison plus. So same for the magpies, I'm going to save the ninja implings just in case I want to open them for clue scrolls later. I could sit here and open all of them to get nothing but alkaboles, but that would be kind of a waste because I don't even have high alk yet. So for the sake of bank space, we'll just keep them in the jars. And of course, I do intend to use all of these skilling materials I got. I saved all the gold bars from eclectics. I'll be using those to gain crafting levels. I saved all the oak planks from eclectics. Obviously, those will go straight into construction. I got a lot of compost, a little bit of super compost, and many buckets of sand, plus a couple of assorted ores and some gems. So I'm gonna try to make use of all of that stuff, as well as 3,000 pure essence, which is gonna save me a lot of time mining later, which is great, and again, a collection of several runes. So then, here's a price check on basically the most valuable items in my bank. giving me a total bank value of about 12 mil, probably upward of 14 if I include the other miscellaneous crap in there. But that's pretty good, I'm feeling good about this. So far, every grind I've done has significantly increased the value of my bank, and even though I don't have much of a use for it yet, it's nice to know that that value is there. Makes me feel like I've actually made progress when, in reality, I've spent 2 weeks trying to get an amulet of glory, which isn't actually going to benefit me until much later on. So, as you may have noticed, the amulets of glory that you get from Dragon Implings are not charged, and you can only recharge them after you have done Hero's Quest. So, until I've done Hero's Quest, even if I use the Fountain of Rune, I will not be able to recharge them, so I cannot even teleport off of these amulets. That said, it's still going to be best in slot necklace for a very long time, so I feel pretty good about having it at this early stage. I don't think it was worth sacrificing 2 weeks of playtime to get, considering I could have got one later by different means, but... This is the grind I decided to do. Legitimately, when I started this grind for Dragon Implings, I thought it would only take a couple of days to get the glories. I didn't expect it would take this long. Let's just go ahead and check the totals very quickly. Several thousand. So, I've got 1100 Earth, 1200 Essence, 1200 Eclectics, 500 Natures, 145 Magpies, 50 Ninjas, and 16 Dragons. Now, the good news is, with 16 Dragon Implings, we actually came in under the drop rate for the Amulets of Glory, so that's good. We could have gone on much longer trying to get those things. And the total number of Implings comes out to 4,567. So I don't think I'm done with Impling grinding forever, but I am going to be staying away from it for a very long time. On that note, I'd like to thank everybody for watching this far. The next video will be coming out much faster. I'm going to go back to hopefully posting on a weekly basis. The next grind I'm going to be taking on is a much, much easier one than this because it's not based on RNG at all. Anyway, thanks everybody for watching. If you liked the video, definitely put a like on the video. Throw me a comment to let me know your thoughts on this series so far, and definitely subscribe if you haven't already. Lastly, have a great day.